Ladies and gentlemen, the victors of the 74th Hunger Games,
Katniss Everdeen and Peter Mallark.
She's not who they think she is. She just wants to save her skin. Simple as that. She has become a beacon of hope for them. So she has to be eliminated. What do you think?
I agree she should die, but in the right way, at the right time. Katniss Everdeen is a symbol. We don't have to destroy her, just her image. Show them that she is one of us now. Let them rally behind that. They're gonna hate her so much, they might just kill her for you.
Please, please, just help me get through this trip.
This trip doesn't end when you get back home.
So what do we do?
From now on, your job is to be a distraction so people forget what the real problems are.
Chins up, smiles on.
There she is, Katniss Everdeen,
the girl on fire!
People are looking at you, Katniss. You've given them an opportunity. They just have to be brave enough to take it.
You saved my life. You gave me a chance.
Yes, to live.
No, to do something.
We have to go, Gale, before they kill us.
They will kill us.
Your entire species must be eradicated.
Her species, sir?
The other victors. Because of her, they all pose a threat. Because of her, they all think they're invincible.
So a big trailer review day here on Beyond the Trailer, and just like with the General Zod teaser that came out for the MTV Movie Awards, I feel we have another divisive trailer here with Catching Fire. But while the argument about Man of Steel in general is whether or not people have faith that Nolan can deliver a great Superman movie, I think that kind of the conversation, the heated, you know, conversation about Catching Fire is whether or not people get the franchise as a whole. And so that's where I think the trailer, this teaser trailer, I don't really think it's a teaser trailer. It seems like a full trailer to me. But I think that's where the conversation is with this Catching Fire trailer. On the one hand, the good news is that I think the people who love the Hunger Games books and the movies, from what I can see, love this trailer. So the teaser trailer does what it needs to do, and that it gets people, it excites the fan base. But I think the bad news is that for people like myself, who just don't quite understand the popularity of The Hunger Games and went to see the first movie out of curiosity, but walked away without really an answer as to why people love it so much, I don't think this trailer is persuasive to get them back into the theater, to get me to go and see the sequel. Of course, I'll see it because, you know, I cover movies, and I'm also interested in something that's immensely popular like this. I just like to see what's going on. But I don't know if as a casual moviegoer, if I didn't like the first movie, I'd be like, oh boy, this is like new, this is different stuff. And that's what's frustrating, because I know this movie does have new and different things. Most notably, a ton of new characters. And to not really tease any of them except for Philip Seymour Hoffman's character, I think is a mistake. I've seen a lot of the comments from people defending that, saying, well, it's just the teaser and it's very early. The movie doesn't come out until November, so we're not gonna really show that yet. But I feel people are so excited, particularly to see Finnick Odair, that to not even have like a shot or something, I think is a mistake. Because, well, and that leads me to my next question about this movie. And I think that the Catching Fire franchise, the Hunger Games franchise, has a little bit of a identity problem. Is it a political drama about the power of, you know, like a Gandhi-like movement of just standing up and maybe not about action? Or is it a movie about people forced to fight to the death? And I think, you know, you could say both, but I think you need to choose a focus. One's the A storyline and one's the B storyline. And I would say from the way this movie Catching Fire is being presented, the political stuff is the A storyline and the arena fighting is the B storyline. Not what I would have chosen. Usually the social commentary is the B storyline. It's the underlying elements. So I'll get into why what I think about that. But I will say first off that I feel you can already tell that the new director is helping the movie, which I think is fantastic. It looks better visually, at least, you know, I think in terms of the color and the camera angles. And I just think that looks better. But back to my comment about if this is a political movie or an action movie, you'll notice there's very little action shown in this trailer, which makes me nervous because I think that for the first film, that was a complaint a lot of people had, especially people who are unfamiliar with the books. They were like, where are the big action sequences that I heard that I was promised because this is a movie about fighting it to the death? You know, it was a lot more talking and you know, being concerned about having to fight. But also the other thing is that when you'll see at the end of the trailer when Katniss runs up to stop Gale from being tortured and she just stands there putting herself in harm's way. I think that's admirable, and I can see why a lot of people like Katniss, because that's a very strong message of peace. You know, she's almost being turned into like a female Gandhi. But I think, or an action movie, to have your action heroine not really do any action, that's a little frustrating. So, but again, the question is, who is Katniss? Is she a Tomb Raider, Ripley, you know, gladiator kind of character? I guess that's the thing. Is she a gladiator or is she a Gandhi? And I think the movie really kind of needs to decide. I think that split personality is maybe what's keeping it from really reaching its full potential. The last comment I want to say about this, though, is that I figured out what my problem is with the Hunger Games movies, at least from a filmmaking standpoint. They seem very small to me. The fact that President Snow and I think Plutarch have that conversation in what looks like a tea room, instead of, you know, for instance, Darth Vader and the Emperor have their discussions in the throne room, just kind of throws me off. And my complaint about the first movie was the extreme lack of world building, I felt. And I know that's because of, I would assume, budget issues. But The Hunger Games made like a ton of money. You know, Lionsgate owns Summit, and that's the Twilight franchise. They have the money, and I know they're spending it, I believe, on Ender's Game. So I don't understand why The Hunger Games continues to kind of look like a CW show. That's my thoughts on it. So write your thoughts down below. Which camp are you? Are you a fan? And if so, what do you think of this teaser trailer? Or are you in the camp with me where you're like, oh, I recognize this is extremely popular, but I don't quite get it. And so what do you think of this teaser trailer from that point of view? So write your thoughts down below. And as I said, big trailer review day. So I hope you check out the other episodes, and thanks for watching. Bye.